Good morning students. Today we will discuss about some important centers of triangle, that is circumcenter, orthocenter, incenter, centroid, excenters and relation among them. Firstly, we should know what is a median, altitude, perpendicular, bisector, internal angle, bisector. We will see all those separately. So first I will explain what is a median. Right, median. If you take a triangle, say this is a triangle, there will be three sides and three vertices, three angles. So similarly, there will be three medians in a triangle. So what is a median? Median is a line joining one vertex to the midpoint of its opposite side. This is midpoint. So this line is called median. This is median. So next, altitude. What is an altitude? We will see what is an altitude. Again, I will take a triangle. Altitude means just a perpendicular line drawn from a vertex to its opposite side. This is what? This is altitude. Next, perpendicular bisector of side. Perpendicular bisector of side. Yes, if I take a triangle, this is the triangle. Perpendicular bisector of a side. If you take this side, the line which is perpendicular to this and which is bisecting this, this line is called perpendicular bisector of the side. Similarly, there will be two more. Yes. These are the median, altitude, perpendicular, bisector. Point of intersection of medians is called centroid. There will be three medians and they are concurrent lines. Their intersection is called centroid. And the common point of concurrence of altitudes is called orthocenter. It is called orthocenter. And perpendicular bisector's point of intersection is circumcenter. Circumcenter. So this is median. There will be three medians. They are concurrent. Their common point is called centroid. Altitude, similarly, three more, total three altitudes will be there. Their common point is orthocenter. Perpendicular bisector, there are three sides now, therefore there will be three perpendicular bisectors of three sides. They are concurrent. Their point of concurrence is called circumcenter. I have taken three different figures to understand better. Now, in a single triangle, I will draw all the three. Say this is a triangle. Let us draw median. What is median? Median is a line joining this and this. This is median. Next, I will draw perpendicular bisector. What is perpendicular bisector? This is perpendicular bisector. The line which is bisecting this and perpendicular to this. Next, what is an altitude? Altitude is this perpendicular line drawn to opposite side. This is altitude. And what is this? This is perpendicular bisector. So this red one is altitude, blue one is median, and green one is perpendicular bisector. So these are very, very important concepts in coordinate system. So let us see properties of these three one by one. Yes, first one we will take centroid. Centroid of a triangle. What is centroid? Centroid is point of intersection of medians. Point of intersection of medians. In a triangle, there will be three sides, three vertices, therefore there will be three medians and they are concurrent lines. Their common point is called centroid. So generally this median, it is denoted by G. Median is generally denoted by capital G. Now we will see about this centroid. Next point, if a triangle is given whose vertices are x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. Say one vertex is x1, y1. Second vertex is x2, y2. And third vertex is x3, y3. If three vertices are given, then centroid G is equal to, centroid can be calculated using this. x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3 and y coordinate y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. This is centroid of the triangle formed by 3 points. When 3 points are given in this way, we find the centroid. Next point. For example, if two vertices of a triangle are given, say capital A is x1, y1, capital B is x2, y2. Third vertex is not given. Instead of third vertex, if centroid is given, say x, y. When two vertices and centroid are given, then we will write the third vertex. It can be written directly, which is 3x minus x1 minus x2. And y coordinate 3y minus y1 minus y2. This is the third vertex. We should apply this when two vertices and centroid are given. And next point, next property. What is a centroid? Centroid is common point of three medians. What are the medians? These lines are medians. The line joining one vertex to the midpoint of its opposite side. Similarly, other two. Their common point is called centroid. So, since centroid is a common point of three medians, it lies on all the three medians and it divides each median in the ratio 2:1. If I take ABC is the triangle and DEF be the midpoints of the three sides, then centroid capital G divides each median, that is, it divides median AD in the ratio 2:1. Also another median in the same ratio 2:1. CF median in the ratio 2:1. Therefore, centroid divide each median in the ratio 2:1. Then next point. If ABC is a triangle, then it will have centroid. Let DEF be the midpoints of three sides. These are the midpoints. If you join the midpoints, then we will get another triangle. Sinana. So in what is here, ABC is a given triangle, DEF is a triangle obtained by joining their midpoints. In this case, centroid of given triangle, centroid of triangle ABC is same as centroid of triangle formed by midpoints D, E, F. Next point, if ABC is a triangle and GB its centroid, this point capital G centroid divides the triangle into three triangles of equal area. So ABC are vertices and G is centroid. G divides the triangle into three triangles of equal area. That is, area of triangle AGB is equal to area of triangle BGC is equal to area of triangle CGA. These three triangles, they are of equal area, and these three are 1/3 of given triangle ABC. 1/3 of given triangle ABC. Next property we will see. If G is the centroid, if G is the centroid of a triangle ABC, if G is the centroid of a triangle ABC, then we have a property. Sum of the squares of the sides. Sum of the squares of the sides is 3 times GA square plus GB square plus GC square. This is also a property. So if G is the centroid of triangle ABC, then AB square plus BC square plus CC square is equal to 3 into GA square plus GB square plus GC square. Yes, next one, orthocenter. Orthocenter. Yes, what is orthocenter? Orthocenter is point of intersection of altitudes. So what is this? This is point of intersection of altitudes. Point of intersection of altitudes. Point of intersection of altitudes is orthocenter. Generally, it is denoted by capital O or capital H. It is generally denoted by capital O or capital H. Next point. Orthocenter of an acute angle triangle. Orthocenter of an acute angle triangle lies inside the triangle. Inside the triangle. If you take an acute angle triangle, that is, all the three angles are less than 90 degrees. In this case, orthocenter lies inside the triangle. Therefore, orthocenter lies inside the triangle. Next property, orthocenter of an obtuse angle triangle. Orthocenter of an obtuse angle triangle lies outside the triangle. What is an obtuse angle triangle? the triangle in which one angle is more than 90 degrees. It will be like this. This is an obtuse angled triangle. So this is obtuse angle. For this angle, if you draw the orthocenter, if you draw three perpendicular lines, three altitudes, then they intersect outside the triangle. So orthocenter will be outside the triangle. Next, number four. Orthocenter of a right angle triangle. Orthocenter of a right angle triangle is the vertex. Is the vertex at the right angle. Is the vertex at the right angle. Yes, if the given triangle is a right angled triangle, say like this. Right angled at this point. If you take a right angled triangle, then its orthocenter will be at the vertex at the right angle. For this triangle, this point, this vertex at the right angle only, right angled triangle. Next, number five. If you take a triangle, say this is a triangle. So you can draw three altitudes, perpendicular lines to the opposite sides. ABC are the vertices. This is first altitude. D is called foot of this altitude. And there will be another. This is perpendicular drawn to next side. And we can draw one more. CF. So AD, BE and CF, they are what? Altitudes. Here DEF, they are called feet of altitudes. DEF are called feet of altitude. Feet of altitude. They are called feet of altitude. The triangle formed by these three. Triangle formed by these 3 feet of altitude. Triangle DEF is called pedal triangle. This is called pedal triangle. Triangle formed by 3 feet of altitudes. Right. Next, we have one more beautiful property. Point number six. If capital O is orthocenter, is the orthocenter, orthocenter of a triangle ABC, of a triangle ABC. ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. Its point of intersection of altitudes, orthocenter is O. Orthocenter is a point, also vertices points only. So three vertices and orthocenter. Now we have 4 points here. Among these 4 points, each point is orthocenter of the triangle formed by remaining 3 points. If you take this point capital O, it is orthocenter of triangle ABC. Similarly, A will be orthocenter of triangle formed by BOC. B will be orthocenter of AOC. And C is orthocenter of AOB. This is very, very important property. Orthocenter, capital O is orthocenter of triangle ABC. Then three vertices and orthocenter. There are 4 points. Among these four points, each point is orthocenter of the triangle formed by the remaining points. So what is O? O is orthocenter. O is orthocenter of triangle formed by remaining three points. Remaining three points means A, B, C. And A is orthocenter of triangle formed by remaining three points, that is BOC. And B is orthocenter of triangle formed by COA. And C is orthocenter of triangle formed by remaining three points, that is AOB. So this is about orthocenter and its properties. Yes, next one, circumcenter. Circumcenter. Yes, what is a circumcenter? Circumcenter is point of intersection. Point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors. Point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors of the sides. What is circumcenter? Circumcenter is point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors of the sides. If you take figure, for example, this is a triangle. There are three sides, no? Perpendicular bisector of this side. What is perpendicular bisector? We have seen the line which is perpendicular to this and bisecting this. It may or may not pass through opposite vertex. Similarly, another perpendicular bisector and one more perpendicular bisector. They are concurrent. Their common point is called circumcenter. Generally, circumcenter is denoted by capital S. This is the circumcenter. There is one more definition for this. What is a circumcenter? If a triangle is given, a circle passes through three vertices. There exists a circle passing through three vertices, which is known as the circumcircle. Center of this circle only circumcenter. Generally, it is denoted by capital S. Therefore, what is circumcenter? Point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors of three sides. It is also the center of circle passing through three vertices, that is center of its circumcircle. So generally circumcircle is denoted by S. Since S, circumcenter, is center of this circumcircle, it is equidistant from three vertices. Circumcenter is equidistant from three vertices. Therefore, we can write a beautiful property. Circumcenter S is equidistant from three sides. Sorry, three vertices. Circumcenter is equidistant from three vertices. That means SA equal to SB equal to SC. Yes, next property, number two, circumcenter of an acute angled triangle. Circumcenter of an acute angled triangle lies inside the triangle. Inside the triangle. If you take an acute angle triangle, if you find its circumcenter, it will lie inside the circle, center of this one. Next, circumcenter of an obtuse angled triangle. Circumcenter of an obtuse angled triangle lies outside the triangle. Outside the triangle. If you take an obtuse angle triangle like this, this is an obtuse angle triangle, this angle is more than 90. It is an obtuse angle triangle. If you take its circle, it will come like this. So what is circumcenter? Center of this circle. It lies here. For this triangle, this is the circumcircle. Therefore, clearly, circumcenter lies inside this. Next, number 4. Circumcenter of a right angled triangle. Circumcenter of a right angled triangle is the midpoint of hypotenuse. Midpoint of the hypotenuse. If you take a right angle triangle, this is right angle. What is its circumcenter? So we will take its circumcircle. This is circumcircle. Center of circumcircle only, circumcenter. This is a circle and this angle is 90. So we know angle in a right angle only 90 degrees. So since it is right angle, this must be a diameter. So midpoint of diameter only, center of this circumcircle. That means in a case of a right angle triangle, its circumcenter is the midpoint of the hypotenuse. Here you please observe this. What is this? This is a diameter. Say this point is ABC. This circle is called circumcircle. This is circumcenter. What is this? This is circumradius. So in a right angle triangle, circumradius is half of hypotenuse. Yes. Okay. We have seen centroid, orthocenter and circumcenter. Now we shall see the relation among these three. I shall take a triangle. This is a triangle. Now we will draw, we will plot orthocenter, circumcenter and centroid. Firstly, orthocenter. What is orthocenter? Orthocenter is point of intersection of altitudes. This is an altitude. There will be three altitudes. Their common point is orthocenter. Here I am taking only one because to represent clear picture. So what is orthocenter? Point of intersection. That means common point of altitudes. Since it is common point of altitudes, it lies on all the altitudes. So this is orthocenter. Next, I shall take median. How to take median? Say this is midpoint of this side. Median is a line joining vertex and midpoint of its opposite side. This is a median. Common point of medians is centroid. Since centroid is common point of medians, it lies on all the three medians. This is G. Next, perpendicular bisectors, point of intersection is circumcenter. I shall take a perpendicular bisector. This is a perpendicular bisector. There will be three, but we are taking only one. Circumcenter is common point of perpendicular bisectors of the sides. Therefore, it lies on all the perpendicular bisectors. We have taken this. So clearly you observe orthocenter, centroid and circumcenter. They will be lying on a line. They will be lying on a line. Therefore, in any triangle, orthocenter, centroid, circumcenter, they lie on a line, that means they are collinear. If I take only this one separately, it will be like this. On extreme left, we will have orthocenter. At the right side, we will have circumcenter, and G lies between these two. And the important point is, if you take G, G divides each median in the ratio 2:1. This is two parts and this is one part. And here these two triangles are similar triangles. Therefore, in a similar triangles, ratio of adjacent sides will be same. Since this is 2:1, this is also 2:1. This is very important concept. Yes, therefore, in any triangle, orthocenter, centroid and circumcenter are collinear. Centroid divides orthocenter, circumcenters in the ratio 2:1 internally. Yes. Yes. Then we have one more in center. We will see what is in center. In center. In center of a triangle. What is in center? In center is point of intersection of internal angle bisectors. There will be three internal angles. These are internal angles. Their bisectors. This is bisector of angle A. And one more angle bisector of B. It is internal. And internal angle bisector of C. These three lines, they are concurrent. Their common point is called in center. What is in center? In center is point of intersection of internal angle bisectors. And it is also the center of in circle. A circle touching three sides is called in circle. It is a center of in circle. So since I is center of in circle, there is a beautiful property. In center is equidistant from sides. Equidistant from sides of the triangle. Circumcenter, it was equidistant from the vertices. SA equal to SB equal to SC. In center is equidistant from sides. Because this is center of the circle, center of a circle. The center is equidistant from all the points on the circle because they are all equal to radii. Therefore, in center is equidistant from sides of the triangle. If in a triangle three vertices are given, capital A x1 y1, capital B x2 y2, and capital C x3 y3. These are the vertices and lengths of the sides. This is important. These are the three sides. Lengths of the sides. The length of the side opposite to A, that means BC. If BC is small a and length of the side opposite to B is small b, that is length of the side CA. And small c is length of the side opposite to C, that is length of AB side. If these are given, then we have in center. What is in center? In center is AX1 plus BX2 plus CX3 whole divided by A plus B plus C. Similarly, Y coordinate, it is AY1 plus BY2 plus CY3 whole divided by A plus B plus C. This is formula to calculate, to find in center of a triangle. Similarly, there will be x enters. X enters. There will be three x enters. We will discuss one x enter first. What is x enter? If a triangle is given, this is a triangle. These are the three sides. Sides means they are finite portions of a line. If you extend this, these are the two lines, and of course the third side is also a finite portion of a line. Say this is triangle ABC. Now firstly, x center opposite to vertex A, that means internal angle bisector of A, and external angle bisectors of B and C. This is external angle bisector of B and C. They are what? They are concurrent. This point is called x center opposite to A. Very simple. Once again, the point of intersection of internal angle bisector of A and external angle bisectors of B and C. This point of intersection is called x center opposite to A. It is also the center of the circle, which is called x circle. There is a circle here. This is in circle. It will be touching all the three sides internally. This circle is also touching all the three sides. You please see, it is touching this side, and also third side. But it lies outside the triangle, therefore it is called x circle opposite to vertex A. Its center is called x center opposite to A. Similarly, there can be two more x centers opposite to B, which will be denoted by I2. Opposite to 2 lies here, which is I3. So to calculate these I1, I2, I3. I1 is what? X center opposite to A, same formula. Wherever A is there, you change its sign. Minus of AX1, BX2, CX3. Whole divided by minus A plus B plus C. And minus AY1 plus BY2 plus CY3. Whole divided by A plus B plus C. Wherever A is there, right? Minus. Similarly, we can write the x centers opposite to B and opposite to C. X center opposite to B, generally it is denoted by I2. I2 means x center opposite to B, no? Therefore, wherever B is there, you will write minus. We will write minus A minus B plus C. And this is AY1 minus BY2 plus CY3 divided by A minus B plus C, x center opposite to B. And third one, x center opposite to C is AX1, this is X1, AX1 plus BX2 minus CX3. Whole divided by A plus B minus C, and its y coordinate AY1 plus BY2 minus CY3 divided by A plus B minus C. These are the x centers respectively opposite to A, opposite to B, opposite to C, and this is in center. And we have a beautiful property. This property is very, very important. So in a triangle we have three x centers and one in center. This is in center denoted by I, and these are three x centers. So if you take three x centers, these are the three x centers. If you join the three x centers, you will get a triangle. This is what a triangle. So for this triangle, for the triangle formed by x centers I1, I2, I3, in center will be ortho center of this. Please note this. What is this point? In center of a triangle is ortho center of triangle formed by x centers. So I in center is ortho center of triangle formed by I1, I2, I3. This is most important point. In center of a triangle is ortho center of triangle formed by remaining three means formed by x centers. Yes, in center we have one more concept. Say this is a triangle ABC. What is in center? Center of in circle or point of intersection of internal angle bisectors. We shall take one. Say this angle bisector of A meets the side in capital D point. What are the lengths of the sides? Length of the side opposite to A, BC side, is small a. Length of the side opposite to B is small b, that is length of the side CA. Length of the side opposite to C is small c, which is AB. So what is this? This point D is the point where the angle, internal angle bisector of A meets the side BC. Here we will have a property. This D point lies on BC and it divides. D divides BC side. Since it lies on the line side BC, it will divide in some ratio. D divides BC in the ratio this is to this. This is to this. If you take the side as CA, then the ratio will be this is to this. So D divides BC side in the ratio C is to B. If you take the line segment BC, then you should begin with this. C is to B. Similarly, there will be two more angle bisectors. No, E point, where it lies? It lies on CA side. Therefore, it divides CA side in the ratio. If the side is BC, ratio is C is to B. Here side is CA, therefore the ratio is A is to C. And one more, F divides, F lies on AB side, no? F divides AB side in the ratio. AB side in the ratio, what ratio? B is to A. So these three points, D, E, F, they divide the three sides in these ratios. And one more thing, what is this? This is internal angle bisector. Two more internal angle bisectors. Their intersection is in center. Therefore, in center lies on all the internal angle bisectors. This I is lying on AD. Therefore, internal in center I divides AD line segment, AD internal angle bisector in the ratio. Since it is lying on this internal angle bisectors, it will be dividing in some ratio. What is that ratio? Sum of these two is to this. Sum of these two means B plus C is 2A. Here line segment is AD, therefore A comes as the second one. This internal angle bisector I also lies on another angle bisector. It will be dividing that. I divides another angle bisector BE in the ratio. AD in the ratio B plus C is to this. BE means it will be C plus A is to B. And it also lies on another angle bisector CF. Therefore, in center divides another angle bisector CF in the ratio A plus B is to C. So these are the points where I divides internal angle bisectors AD, BE and CF. And we have one more center, 9-point circle. 9-point circle. What is a 9-point circle? See, Nana, if a triangle is given, say this is a given triangle, let ABC be the vertices. These are the three vertices. In this triangle, we will have three midpoints. I am taking rough figure, approximate figure. Say DEF be the midpoints. So I have taken midpoints of sides. Midpoints of the sides are DEF. These are the midpoints. And I will draw the altitudes. This is first altitude, second altitude, third altitude. These points are called feet of the altitude. Their intersection is orthocenter. So feet of altitude. Feet of altitude. I will denote them by x, y, z. Say how many feet of altitude? They are 3. X, Y, Z. Then this is orthocenter, no? Midpoint of orthocenter and this vertex. Midpoint of orthocenter and another vertex. And one more. So midpoints of orthocenter and vertices. Vertices. They are also 3 points. Say this is P, this is Q, and this is R. How many points have come? P, Q, R. So now in this triangle, 3 midpoints, 3 feet of altitude, and 3 midpoints of orthocenter and vertices. Total, they are 9 points. Through these 9 points, there exists, there pass a circle. Like this. This circle is passing through 3 midpoints, 3 feet of altitudes, and 3 midpoints of orthocenter to the vertices. Total 9 points. Through these 9 points, a circle will pass. That circle is called 9-point circle. This circle is called 9-point circle. So its center is called center of 9-point circle. So what is 9-point circle center? It will be midpoint of orthocenter and circumcenter. If O is orthocenter of the triangle and S is circumcenter of the triangle, then center of 9-point circle, which is denoted by N, that will be midpoint of OS. And radius of this 9-point circle, radius of 9-point circle, radius of 9-point circle will be half of circumradius, half of circumradius. Half means 1/2. So this circum, what is circumcircle? This will be circumcircle. This is 9 point circle. Radius of 9 sub point circle will be half of circumcircle. So this is about centers, important centers of a triangle. Ortho center, circumcenter, centroid, incircles, excircles and 9 point circle. Yes.